What does a man do when consumed by a possessive state of loneliness? For Sy Parish, played by Robin Williams, this torment is a darkness that plagues him on a daily basis. One-hour photo, written and directed by Mark Romanek, blurs the lines between love and heartbreak. I really like the opening to this film, setting up the mystery of why this man is being held in police custody. As the plot unfolds, working at a one-hour photo lab in a Savmart superstore, Sy's longing for a family of his own becomes a twisted obsession. He declares the Yorkin family, a family of three he has known for many years, to be his best customers. This may be true, but really, they're his favorite customers. He loves them, in a possessive way. The Yorkin family embodies what he desires most in a loving family. Developing their family photographs, he has watched them grow over many years. In a deranged manner, this makes him feel like part of the family. Photography is a key theme explored throughout. Typically, photos capture the best bits by capturing the memories we wish to cherish. Why would somebody take a photograph of something they would rather forget? This is something Sy makes reference to, illustrating a rare element of beauty for existentialism.
And if these pictures have anything important to say to future generations, I was here. I existed.
His internal monologue describes this best, where he is looking at some old photos. Despite these people being strangers to him, he chooses to recognize their photos as a statement of their existence. Robin Williams brings a fascinating performance where you ultimately lose yourself in the character. It's great to see the man in a dramatic role, especially one that is deliberately layered to be unsettling. These elements make you question the events taking place before your eyes. I felt this mostly from the home invasion sequence. Sy lets himself into the Yorkin family home and realizes he is alone. He decides to get comfortable, where tension is built from the family returning early. Rather than fearing a stranger in the house, he's instead warmly welcomed, only for Sy to snap back to reality. This is where the interactions with the Yorkin family become an ongoing struggle. It becomes an unusual attraction where Sy wants to become noticed and recognized as part of the family. This can be seen where he goes out of his way to purchase and read the same book as Nina Yorkin. He even approaches the son Jacob, offering him an action figure as a gift. His actions seem harmless at first, but his obsession harbors a disturbing secret. Sy keeps copies of their family photos for himself and proudly displays them. Adding more to this shrine, he declares himself the uncle of the family.
These your relations?
Yes, that's my little nephew Jake.
He invades their privacy without realizing there are boundaries he should not cross. Who exactly is he to the family?
Oh, right, Sy the photo guy.
Right.
He's nothing short of a job title. This awkward conversation between Will Yorkin and Sy on the shop floor juxtaposes how each character feels about one another. Sy is just another generic shop employee, but seeing Will in the flesh, Sy is starstruck. He has only known the man through photographs. Despite how creepy Sy comes across, his intentions are depicted as meaningful. I really enjoyed the scenes that take place inside his apartment, where we further see the possessive nature spiral out of control. With this in mind, his social interactions become questionable. His kind personality comes across as genuine. Even while serving customers, he maintains a level of professional charisma despite obvious vulnerabilities seen behind closed doors. Having worked as a photo technician for over a decade, he is evidently good at his job. He shows passion in his work. This can be seen where he argues over the servicing of the photo machine. Each photo must be made perfect to Sy's standard.
All I'm asking you to do is look at these prints. Nobody gives a shit until those shifts are in the double digits.
Why must these photos be perfect? Well, as we know, a lot of them enter his own personal collection. When Sy develops a roll of film for another customer, this is where the plot takes a dark turn. Printing a set of photos for a young woman named Maya, he sees Will Yorkin having an affair with her, documented in the pictures. With how fond Sy has become of the Yorkin family, this revelation destroys him. It breaks his heart, where he struggles to contain his emotions. It obliterates the image of the perfect family he once had. He feels like a victim, which becomes his downfall. By witnessing this, there's an obligation to let Nina Yorkin know about the affair, and he ensures ensures that she sees the photos. This knowledge possesses him, as reflected by this wonderful horror-inspired scene showing Sy bleeding from the eyes. Confronted by the shop manager, I genuinely felt sorry for Sy throughout this sequence. With his abrupt behavior and having now been caught cutting costs and taking merchandise for himself, he is fired. And so, hurt by those around him and hurt internally by Will Yorkin, the plot takes on a revenge storyline. The symbolism of scratching out Will Yorkin's face in every single family photo adds to how hurt Sy is. This final act for his character deliberately shows an irrational change in behavior. On his final day working for Savmar, he steals a large knife to use as a threatening weapon. Lashing out at those around him, he threatens the store manager's daughter with a series of photos taken from a distance. I felt this was used as a distraction while he went in pursuit of Will Yorkin. With the police closing in, he holds Will and Maya hostage in a hotel room. With how deranged his behavior becomes, I like how his intentions are extremely unclear. Rather than killing the pair, he forces them to pose for a series of nude photographs. I interpreted this scene as more of a psychological torment of the two characters, something that would scar them for life rather than killing them. With Sy's actions taken into account, I would argue that he isn't capable of murder. In one last attempt to escape, Sy is finally caught by the police. Left alone in the interrogation room, photographs are his true comfort. His story depicted an unusual love he could not possibly contain, and when he saw this shatter, his obsessive world was destroyed beyond repair. I really enjoyed the way this character was written. Robin Williams did a phenomenal job capturing the emotional complexity of a man who felt unnoticed by the world. I would also like to highlight the evocative soundtrack for this movie. Leading up to the end credits, the music referred to as Sy's theme is a stunning track, evoking a sense of loneliness through its heartbreaking melody. A huge thank you to those who recommended this film on my recent update video. If you have any future suggestions, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Please do leave a like if you enjoyed this video, and for more content, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel, DVD Review Studios.
Are you threatening me?